And now the second section, as mentioned before, is the striking section, which you know who in Japanese. Now it's always great to start from the kendo mai, or the sword stance. So right foot forward, turn in front again, two hands distant from the jo. So, just like that. It's not too close here. We don't want to lose the distance from the front. So the hands are extended again, not overextended, but natural. And the first one is called Shomen no Chikomi, Shomen, the front of the head, Uchi is the strike. So basically it's the front head strike. Again, I start with the Kenkamai, sword stance. Now it's almost the same as the second Suburi of the Dokken. Before you strike, again, you turn the back leg, back foot, step back, raise the jo, front of the head, a little bit tilted up and behind. Open up the hips, drop inside. As you move forward, the jo drops, and from the front, from the foot, back, open. And now the second movement is called Ranzoku Chikomi. So now it's connected with the previous movement. There's an extra movement added right here. Let's turn the foot back, step back, again open up, step forward, strike. Now the back foot is going to lean forward, make a full step. And since the right foot is forward, the tip of the jo is going to fall, and the hand is going to go straight up through the center line. And again, it goes behind the back, adjust the back foot, and the hips, use the hips, and strike. This is the first movement. Cut and strike. So now the next couple movements in this section are again going to be a connection between the first section and the uchi move. So this time we're going to connect the uchi with the gedan geshi, the lower turn that we looked at before. Starting once more from the sword stance, step back. Cut. And now the back foot leads. I take the whole jo. As the left hand slides back, the whole jo is taken. Wide big stance. The front foot follows. Hide the jo. Turn the hips and strike. And once more from the front. Back. Strike. Hide the jo. Now the fourth movement again in connection between the first section and the second section. It's going to start as the previous movement, the first movement. Cut. And now back foot guides. As the back foot guides, left hand takes the jo, slides through the right hand, and the whole jo. I adjust with a slight step the back foot. Again, the whole body, the full center, strike behind, looking forward. One in front. One, and the last one in the second section is called Aikido Jo. So again, it's a connection of two movements, different from the last the previous movements in the second section. We're not going to go back. This time we're going to go straight forward. And now again the shirotsuki, the back strike, press, would be pretty much impossible to do it here. So the left hand, the back hand has to go over the right hand. It has to slide. As I step back, lead with the back foot, take the whole jo, and press. Now, the left hand slides, right hand brings the jo back, right foot helps to make the movement, and first step.